Welcome to Professor Matt, Electronics for Beginners. Today we are going to learn about diodes. Simply, a diode is a two-terminal electronic component that only conducts current in one direction. Diode behavior is analogous to behavior of a hydraulic device called a check valve. A check valve allows fluid flow through it in only one direction. Here, the two check valves try to flow water in different directions, but current flow is permitted in only one direction. Current flow is prohibited in other directions. Check valves are pressure-operated devices. They open and allow flow if the pressure across them is of the correct polarity to open the gate. If the pressure is of the opposite polarity, the pressure difference across the check valve will close and hold the gate so that no flow will occur. Same as check valves, diodes are also pressure operated devices. Electron pressure is called as voltage. The most common kind of diode in modern circuit design is the semiconductor diode. Semiconductor diodes are symbolized in schematic diagrams such as the figure. The direction of the diode symbol's arrowhead points at the direction of the currents in conventional flow. The opposite is true when electron flow is used, where the direction of electron is always against the arrowhead. Here we have two simple circuits. Look at the diodes carefully. They are in opposite directions. Let's see what will happen after the switch is on. Only one circuit is working. That is because the diode will either allow or prevent current through the lamp depending on the polarity of the applied voltage. When the polarity of the battery is such that current is allowed to flow through the diode is said to be forward biased. Conversely, when the battery is backward and the diode blocks the current, the diode is said to be reverse biased. Semiconductor diodes are the most commonly used diode type today, and those are the first semiconductor electronic devices. Semiconductor diode is just a PN junction that connected to two electrical terminals, P-type and N-type, inside a single crystal of semiconductor. The N-side contains free electrons that can move through the conductor. These electrons can act as the charge carriers. Since electrons are negatively charged, we call them as negative type or N-type. This is a silicon lattice. Here, every silicon atom has 4 electrons in valence band and they are all bonded to atoms. If we remove a silicon atom and replace it by using phosphorus atom that has 5 electrons in valence band, it also has to behave like a silicon atom by bonding 4 electrons with surrounding silicon atoms. But what happens to the final electron? It is not bonded to any atom. It is a free electron. Those can move freely. This is how N-type semiconductors are created. Now let's talk about P-type semiconductors. The P-side contains an excess of holes. An electron hole is the lack of an electron at a position where one could exist. As an example, think about this silicon lattice. Every atom bonded to 4 other atoms. What if we remove a silicon atom and introduce a boron atom that only has 3 electrons in its valence band? Boron atoms try to behave like silicon atom, but it needs one more electron to complete 4 bonds like silicon. So it's searching for an electron. That is what we call as a hole, simply a lack of electron. Since in a normal atom or crystal lattice, the negative charge of the electron is balanced by the positive charge of the atomic nucleus. The absence of an electron leaves a net positive charge at the hole's location. Holes are not actually particles, but rather quasi-particles. This is how p-type semiconductors are made. Such as that we can introduce new atoms into non-conducting atomic lattice and make it a conductor. This process is called semiconductor doping. Now we know about n-type and p-type semiconductors. Let's see what happens in the p-n junction. At the junction, the free electrons in the n-type are attracted to positive holes in the p-type. For ease of understand, let's pay attention to only one electron. Due to this electron movement, total charge of n side becomes positive 1 and p side becomes negative 1. This happens to every electron near the junction. So, in the n-type, a region near the junction becomes positively charged. In the p-type, a region near the junction becomes negatively charged. The result is a region near the junction that acts to repel the mobile charges away from the junction through the electric field V1. The region near the p-n interface lose their neutrality and most of their mobile carriers forming the depletion layer. The depletion region is devoided of available charges and carriers and act as an insulator. Right, now let's talk about forward biasing. In forward bias configuration, the p-type is connected with the positive terminal and the n-type is connected with the negative terminal. The positive potential applied to the p-type material attracts the electrons. Those are in the depletion layer. While the negative potential applied to the n-type material repels the electrons. This causes neutralization of the depletion layer, reducing its width. With increasing forward bias voltage, the depletion zone eventually becomes thin enough that the zone's electric field cannot counteract charge carrier motion across the p-n junction. This takes a certain minimum voltage to accomplish, called the forward voltage. For silicon diodes, the typical forward voltage is 0.7 volt. For germanium diodes, the forward voltage is only 0.3 volts. If an external voltage that is greater than and opposite to the built-in voltage is applied, a current will flow and the diode is said to be turned on. Right, we know the depletion layer normally prevents the current flow through the diode. Let's see what happens in reverse bias configuration. The p-type is connected with the negative terminal and the n-type is connected with the positive terminal. We say the diode is in reverse bias. More electrons in the n-type material near the junction are pulled away from the junction and combine with the holes in p-type near the junction, leaving behind the charged ion and causing the width of the depletion layer to increase. If a reverse biasing voltage is applied across the p-n junction, this depletion region expands, further resisting any current through it. Let's try to understand the characteristic curve of p-n junction diode. The characteristic curve of a junction diode is also called an IV curve. It is typically a graph showing the current flow at a different forward voltages. The current is typically on the y-axis and the voltage on the x-axis. We know diode has three regions, p-type end, n-type end, and the middle depletion layer. Let's set the n-type end at the 0 volt and make the voltage of p-n a variable. We are using the voltage of p-n to plot the graph. If we increase the voltage of the p-n, we can see the depletion layer is becoming thinner, because the diode is at forward bias. But we still can't see any current go through the diode. Let's increase the voltage furthermore. Now a huge current can go through the diode because the depletion layer vanished. It is now like a conductor. Let's zoom in. The current flow started nearly at 0.7 volt. That is the forward voltage of this diode. We know increasing the voltage of the PN makes the diode a conductor. What happens to the diode if we decrease the voltage of PN? See, nothing. Diode is now reverse biased. The depletion layer expands with the decreasing of the voltage. This blocks the current flow. We can say any increase in reverse bias voltage will keep the reverse current to almost zero until it goes to the breakdown point. This is the maximum reverse voltage that diode can handle. We can clearly identify three regions of this curve: forward region, reverse region, and the breakdown region. The forward voltage is 0.7 volt for silicon diodes and 0.3 volt for germanium diodes. And normally, the breakdown voltage can go up to minus 50 volts. In practical cases, diode allow very low current to go through it at the reverse biased region. It is called leakage current. That is all about diode. See you in next video.